manufacturer mourns the passing of the Philippine Central Bank Chief Nestor Espenilla Jr., who succumbed to tongue cancer after a year-long battle. He was 60. Here's a look at the legacy of the man who rose through the ranks with a dream of financial inclusivity.
Nestor Espenilla Jr. had big shoes to fill when it was finally his time to guard the Philippines' monetary authority, replacing Amando Tetangco Jr., a world-acclaimed central banker with stellar accomplishments. Espenilla faced the challenge head-on with a huge dream: democratizing the country's banking system.
I didn't have any visions that the life of a governor would be a walk in the park. So I come prepared for this job.
It seems Espenilla had been destined to take the helm of the country's central bank. At the tender age of 10, his eyes were opened to the banking sector when his mother established a small rural bank in Masbate. The venture grew and now has several branches in the province and in neighboring Sorsogon. Espenilla went on to pursue a career in the industry. He graduated magna cum laude from the University of the Philippines with a degree in business economics and a master's degree in business administration. He also finished a master of science degree in policy science in Japan. He joined the central bank in 1981 as a debt analyst while still at the university before moving in to the bank supervision area. He was named assistant governor in 2002, then deputy governor 3 years later. Espenilla was in charge of disciplining banks and was known to be the Banco Central ng Pilipinas' proverbial bad cop. Among his stringent policies as the BSP's head of supervision and examination sector, the landmark 1 billion peso fine on Philippine Bank RCBC over the Bangladesh bank cyber heist. But his central bank leadership was marked by the central bank's hawkish stance as the country grappled with soaring consumer prices. As the Philippines' inflation gatekeeper, the central bank was pushed to raise its benchmark interest rate by a total 175 basis points to 4.75% last year after initially facing criticism for being slow to act to rein in price growth. Espenilla's biggest battle, however, was against his tongue cancer, which forced him to take intermittent leaves during his governorship. But the illness did not take away his funny bone.
Today, you know, I have some problems with the liquidity flow, and I'm always dehydrated.
He succumbed to his illness on Saturday, February 23rd. Nesting, as he is fondly called by family and friends, is survived by his wife Tess, their daughter, two sons, and a grandchild. He left the central bank with a legacy of championing financial inclusion programs, including Peso Net and InstaPay, which paved the way for cashless transactions among businesses and ordinary consumers, and Pitaka, which aims to help overseas Filipino workers and their families save and invest their hard-earned money.
They say that it can be lonely at the top. Even when the going gets tough, my fervent wish is that I never lose sight of where I came from. Ako ay laking BSP.
Rain Musngi, ABS-CBN News.
Catch the Boss Legacy Special of Philippine Central Bank Governor Nestor Espenilla Jr. this Thursday, February 28th at 8 p.m. on ANC. You will also be able to watch the Legacy Special on ANC 24/7 on Facebook and YouTube.